today. If you're excited, can I get you to give God some praise in this place? This morning and tonight, we were watching a little football, and I was intrigued as I watched, I believe, the Cleveland Browns play. And as I looked on the field, I saw a saying right above their name that said, "It takes all of us." My husband always says it only works when we all do it. And then I thought about in the Word of God that it says that the people were together in one place and on one accord. And somebody say, suddenly, a sound from heaven came as a mighty rushing wind that filled the temple of God to drop in this place on today. So I don't want you to come for a show. I need you to come with your praise on the inside. I need you to open up your mouth, lift up your hands, and give God the praise that's due his name on today. I know you said I came to see Pastor John P. Key, but guess what? I came for the glory of God to fall in this place. On Sunday nights, about this time, we usually take off of our sofa in fancy clothes. Back in the sanctuary, it's because we want to see the glory of God. Now, I'm going to let you practice in this place. All the way on I-20. Come on, can I get you to give God some praise? Who is our God? He's the Lord strong and mighty. Who is our God? He's the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your head, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors. King of glory shall come in. I want to welcome you on behalf of our lead pastor, Billy the Third, myself, and the entire Dream Center Church family. I also want to welcome our virtual audience. We see you out there, and we are ready to have an exciting move in the presence of God on tonight. So on hands, shout unto the Lord with a voice of triumph. And as we do it, the glory of God is gonna fill this place. As we do it, the presence of God is gonna fill. People will be. It's in Jesus' name. You're welcome. You're welcome.
Jesus.
Let us see you.
Jesus,
till I get my miracle. Say it, church.
Let us see you.
Jesus, like never before.
Oh, God.
Let us see you. Jesus, like never before. Let us see Jesus.
Oh,
now.
Let us see
Jesus.
Let us see you face to face.
Let us see you lifted up like never before. Isaiah said in the book of Isaiah chapter 6, he said, I saw the Lord and his train filled the temple. I want you to touch two or three people around you tonight and tell them that tonight is your night that you're gonna get full. Wrong person, find somebody, even those of you who are online, put it into the chat. That tonight is the night that you're gonna get full. I know that's not good English, but tonight is the night where we get full. So
So it's my night to lead you into a time of prayer. But just like Pastor D said, you're going to get out of it what you put into it. And so tonight, I want to set a foundation for the type of prayer that we're going to pray. The Bible says that our thanksgiving does something to heaven. Jesus takes the bread and the five loaves and he breaks it and he thanks God, and God causes increase to come. So I looked at the word thankful. I said, I gotta pray about thanksgiving. It's thankful. So let me look. I dissected that word, and the word thankful has a suffix that's F-U-L. That F-U-L means to be characterized by, to be full of, to be able to. And the last one is the one that threw me. It says, as much as will fill, F-I-L-L. So to be thankful, that thanks. David said, I'll bless the Lord at all times. To be thankful is to be characterized by thanksgiving. Kind of like the one leper that came back and said, thank you. To be thankful is to be able to give thanks. So let everything that have breath thank, praise the Lord. But it's the as much as will feel that still throws me off a little bit. And I heard the Lord say, Prashia, tell them, and I want you to pray from the place that thanksgiving is what expands your capacity to receive what I have for you. I'll talk to the people over here. I'll spend the last 2 minutes of this prayer thanking God. But as you thank God, I want you to see yourself increasing in capacity to receive everything that God has for you. I prophesy tonight that you will end this year full. I prophesy tonight that this is your year to end full. You will end full. That means you're going to have favor. That means you're going to have understanding. That means you're going to be fully loaded. And I do declare that you will be full of light, because when you walk into this blessing, you're going to have peace in your mind. I need a few people who are thankful tonight to open up your mouth and set an atmosphere in this place that causes heaven to respond. Somebody tell him how good he is. Somebody tell him how great he is. Come on, open up your mouth and thank him, because he's unto him who is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that I could ever ask or think. Now unto Jehovah Jireh, now unto Jehovah Nissi, I do give you praise. For it is good that we praise it, but praise is comely to the upright. And so tonight, that word comely means to attract. So let your thanksgiving attract some blessings. Wonderful, beautiful creator, magnificent, holy, Alpha Omega, he cannot resist this. We thank an able God tonight. We thank a God who will give us the grace to finish for the next 35 days of this year. You're going to make sure that I finish full. I hear the Apostle Paul declare to the Philippian church, carry tonight to the dreams in the church of Atlanta, and that he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord says. I do declare that I am confident in this very thing. He that begun what he started in the beginning of this year, he will perform it. Slap a few people high five and tell them, I'm finishing full. I'm finishing full. I would be remiss of my prophetic responsibility if I did not announce what the Lord told me to announce tonight. When the prophet comes to announce and to accelerate. And so I prophesy that tonight is the season of revival. This is that the prophet spoke of. Let tonight initiate something in the heavenlies. Let tonight trigger something. Somebody open up your mouth, and I need you to release. release a shout of praise. And as you release this shout, send it to the four corners of this state. I don't know where he is, but I prophesy, Senator Warnock, God's gonna finish what he started.
Get you to do this? Can I get you to open up your mouth and release a crazy praise in this atmosphere? Come on, if you agree with everything that's been released in the atmosphere, praise! Let's go! Let me have everybody put your hands on it like this. Let's go. Hey, got that crazy praise. Here we go. What you say?
Magnify the Lord. Come on, do it with me. Let's exalt his holy name. Cause this is how you get free.
Free from all your pain. Yeah. Free from all your care. Gonna lift your hands. He will.
So we
he will
be together, right here. We
why don't you praise him? Stop complaining. Go ahead and praise him.
Let's go. Hey.
Give God a crazy praise.
Hey.
Give God a crazy praise.
Bring it on with us.
Praise.
Give God a crazy
praise. Give God a crazy praise.
Let's go tell you what you're saying.
Don't you dare give up. Don't you dare lose hope. Just keep holding on. You got to do your part.
Where you at, Trinity?
Complaining, go ahead and praise him.
Give God a crazy,
give God a crazy praise.
Give God a crazy,
give God a crazy praise. Oh, why don't you praise him?
Stop complaining.
Stop complaining.
Let's go,
go ahead and praise him. Give God a crazy praise.
Give God a crazy,
give God a crazy praise.
Oh, so we say this and we say, lose faith if you want to. With a mustard seed, let me tell you what you're gonna do. Look up, put praise on it, and do your dance. Get it cracking like it used to be. Prepare to go to war when you get on your knees. And when the wind start to blow, when the storm won't cease, wood on the wall, but the pain won't leave. I dare you to put praise on it and release the sound that'll break every chain on it. Break free like a brand new day. Testify how to stop rolling away. Cause God is alive now. He utters every word he. Come on, get crunk, put praise on it. Say, why don't you praise him?
Why don't you praise him?
Stop complaining.
Stop complaining.
Let's go, hey.
Go ahead and praise him.
Give God.
Give God a crazy praise.
Hey. Give God a crazy praise.
Give God a crazy praise.
Oh. Let's go, hey.
Why don't you praise him?
Stop complaining.
Stop complaining.
Go ahead and praise him. Give God.
Give God a crazy praise.
You wanna give God a crazy praise?
Give God a crazy praise.
Then why don't you praise him?
Why don't you praise
stop
him?
Stop complaining.
Stop complaining.
Let's go praise.
Go ahead. Give God a crazy praise.
You ought to give God.
Give God a crazy praise.
Oh, 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 oh.
Why don't you praise
stop
him?
Complaining.
Stop complaining.
Sing it out, praise.
Go ahead and praise him.
Give God.
Give God a crazy praise.
Give God a crazy praise. Here we go right here. Now we're say, go!
Go make it crazy.
Hey, turn up. Let's go. Let's go. Sing it out. Say, go ahead, get crazy.
crazy praise.
Look at somebody and tell them,
why don't you praise him? Stop complaining
and praise him.
Give God,
you got a crazy praise.
One more time. Somebody in the balcony to sing it. Stop complaining. She gonna do. Hey. One more time. One more time. Say. You gotta put your hands on it. Somebody told me if you give him a crazy praise, he'll give you a crazy blessing. I said, somebody told me if you give God a crazy praise, he'll drop a crazy blessing on your house. I need somebody to open your mouth and just give God a crazy praise. I'm talking to my online sanctuary. You gotta give God a crazy praise. It's happening in this room already. Give God a crazy praise. Last time. Give God a crazy praise. Put your hands together and open your mouth. Y'all help me thank God for our young people. Thank God for the next generation of kingdom leaders. They're not all dope boys. They're not all twerk girls. We're raising up some prophets and apostles and some lawyers and some doctors and some athletes. How about this? We raising up some senators and some representatives. And let me just go on and prophesy the next black president coming up out of the ATL. Let me just say. Y'all scared. I said the next black president coming out of Atlanta. Help me thank God for our young people one more time. Did y'all get blessed by that tonight? And for those of you who don't know that, that is actually our song that's on the Contagious record. Brianna is singing that on the Contagious record. Y'all help me thank God for Bree one more time. She's just such a blessing. Listen, this is what we typically do. We were supposed to, but we kind of got our wires crossed, so we're doing it after the song. But what we do is, based on the order of the tabernacle, we don't sing and do all this other stuff first. Based on the order of the tabernacle in Exodus 25, the first thing that they did, Bishop Dixon, was to make an acceptable sacrifice. This is what gave them a legal right to access the Holy of Holies, to move from the outer court through the inner court and the Holy of Holies, so that we have a legal right to have an encounter in the presence of God. How many of y'all didn't just come for your favorite song tonight, but you came because you need something from God? I need God to touch me tonight. When I was preparing this weekend, the Lord said to tell you, he said, I want you to have an expectation. Yeah, this is what the Lord put on my heart. So what we're going to do tonight, everybody in this room, I want you to get a $35 seat, one of you. There are 35 days left in this year. And I'm believing that every day for the rest of this year, God's going to be working miracles. every day for the rest of the year, God's going to, look at somebody, tell them, every day for the rest of the year, God's going to be working miracles. They're going to put it on the screen how you can give. I want every person in this room, no excuses, all your money in black on Black Friday. So I want you, everybody, look at your neighbor, tap them on the shoulder, say, Bishop's talking to you. As a matter of fact, look at them and tell them, as good as you look, you need to sow. Amen. You need to sow double for all the trouble. Amen. Come on, get your seed and let's get ready to give. Dream Center, you know how to do it. We're going to give tonight and we're going to put pressure on this anointing that's in the room tonight. Listen, our vote is our voice. We're going to put a seed in the ground tonight because we're in faith that God is raising up legislators who will perpetuate the will of God in this nation. We need prophets in politics. Tap your neighbor on the shoulder, tell them, we need prophets in politics. We need men and women who can hear from God and men and women who will obey God after they have heard. There is such a man in the room tonight by the name of Senator Raphael Warnock. Will you help me to thank God for him tonight? Dream Center, don't embarrass me. Will you help me thank God? He's our senator. He belongs to us. And we thank God for this gift, not just to the body of Christ, but this gift to the country. I want everybody, get your $35 seed. We're going to sow it tonight. Bishop, why 35? Because I'm putting a seed on every day that remains in this year. Was have an expectation that the blessing of the Lord is going to be on your house every day for the rest of this year. Can y'all bring us, y'all ready? Y'all gonna sing something so we can give tonight? Listen, I'm gonna decree a blessing over your seed. After Dance and Mime is coming back and Senator Warnock is coming in just a moment. Will y'all help me thank God, Dream Center? We've got pastors who have come from all across the country to stand with Atlanta, Georgia tonight. Will you help me thank God for those pastors who are in the building tonight? I know you came for Key, but help me thank God for all of our pastoring friends who are in the building tonight. We give God praise for them. You got your seed ready? We make a confession of faith over our seed. Y'all want to put that on the screen? We make a confession of faith over our seed. Now, let me just say this tonight. Let me just decree a blessing tonight. I decree and declare double for your trouble. In Jesus' name, amen and amen and amen. Come on, let's give. Come on, you can bring your seed to the altar. If you're giving electronically, I know most of you are, just come and tap the altar with your phone. Just come and sow tonight. You can do it by Giblify. You can do it by Venmo. You can do it by Zelle. You can do it by PayPal. Either way, just come and tap the altar tonight and get your seed in the ground.
God is for me. I have victory.
Sing another song. God is. Sing another song for y'all. And sing it from the beginning. Come on, everybody's going to sow tonight. Just come and get your seed in the ground. Come on. Yes, Lord. You can just drop it anywhere on the altar, wherever you want to drop it. Just get your seed in the ground tonight.
Everybody clap your hands as we give here. Come on. Hey. Here's the thought. If God's going to get the glory, we're going to be the ones to give it to him. Hey. Woo. The song says, all I have is all because of you. You took my life and made it brand new. My future's safe in the palm of your hands. With every breath I breathe, it's call and response. You say it here, say it. All I have is all because of you.
All I have is all because of you.
You took my life and made it brand new. My future's safe in the palm of your hand. And with every breath I pray you again. Yes, listen. With my life I will worship. With all my heart I will sing. As we lift your name high, Lord, receive this offering. Cause it's yours. It's yours. It's yours. You say it. With my life, say it.
With my life I will worship.
As we lift your name high, Lord, receive this ring. Cause it's yours. You don't have to wait. Uh-huh. I want. Why he said, you don't have to wait on me. I'll do it right now. Somebody raise your voice and do it now. Yeah. I won't let a rock cry out. I won't let a rock cry. You don't have to wait on me.
We got a couple of things we got to do tonight. Somebody is walking out of this room with a miracle. Look down your row and see if you can find who it is. Who is it on my row that's going home with a miracle? So y'all telling me there are miracles all over this room tonight? Listen, the Spirit of God is here. And listen, we're going to pause for just a moment. And I believe with all of my heart that God is all right with this, that God would have us to mix worship and justice and politics and legislation. I was having a conversation just a little earlier tonight, and this should have always originated in the house of God. If we're going to win this election, it's going to be with us. And I'm decreeing and declaring that folk who had no intention on voting for Raphael Warnock are going to get in the voting booth, and the Spirit of God is going to arrest them. Can I get somebody else to decree it and declare it? That God is turning the hearts of people in the direction. I ain't telling nobody who to vote for. I'm just telling you what the Spirit of God. Because I can't tell you who to vote for, but I can tell you what I believe. That people are going to get in the voting booth and their hearts are going to be turned towards God's man. I want to call to the stage. There are so many pastors who literally preached in their church, ran to the airport, jumped on a plane, and flew to Atlanta to stand with. And I want to invite every one of those pastors, whether you flew here, whether you drove here, whether you got here on a skateboard or a go-kart, I don't know how you got here tonight, but I want to invite every pastor to the stage tonight, and let's stand together. We're not in competition. Ain't nobody jealous. Ain't nobody mad. We're just all one family. Come on, Pat, come stand with me tonight. I don't want to start calling names, but Dewey Smith, this don't look like it used to look last time you was here. Let's thank God for Pastor Dewey Smith from the House of Hope. God bless you. Come on, I need y'all to keep clapping until every pastor gets on this stage. Let's celebrate our leadership in this city. Come on. Dreams building. I need y'all to help me thank God for these pastors. Y'all help me thank God for every Moses in this building. My goodness. We have a father. I want to acknowledge one of the fathers of the city, Reverend Dr. Gerald Durley is in the building. Will you help me to thank God for this man of God? I need a better hand clap than that, y'all. Come on now. Look at somebody and tell them, even if it's just us, there's still enough of us. Tell them we're going to change the world. I see your eyeballs. Look at your neighbor. Tell him, even if it's just us, there's still enough of us. We're going to change the world. Will you help me welcome to the microphone at this time the Bishop James Dixon from Houston, Texas? Will you help me to receive him? He's coming to the mic.
We honor the glory of God in this place. We honor the set man of this house, the voice, the vessel, the vehicle that God is using to transform lives from the world. Let's praise God for Bishop William Murphy III. Come on. Come on, let's praise God for him. Oh, come on, do better than that. I'm honored to be here tonight with my friend and brother. He has been several times in Houston. Always a blessing, known him for decades. I celebrate tonight his peculiar gift. He's a peculiar gift of the body of Christ. He's a prophetic worshiper. He is a prophetic worshiper. And you know that because every time he speaks, preaches, and ministers, he worships prophetically, and the people who receive it become visible manifestations of the power of God in the presence of people. You ought to just celebrate the man of God that God is using here at the Dream Center one more time. Come on. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm honored to be here tonight as I celebrate as well all of these men and women of God who stand tonight in this place. What a blessing it is to see clergy coming together from across the United States of America. Would you celebrate, come on, the preachers, the pastors, the bishops, the apostles who are here on tonight. We thank God for all of you and for the thousands who are out of the city who are here in spirit, who could not fly in, but they're sending their prayers and they're sending their financial support because we are on a mission. I said, we are on a mission. Dr. Freddie Haynes is in the airport at DFW. His flight got canceled. He said, Bishop, let him know I'm with you all the way. He's waiting to send in an offering. So many people across this country. Let me say this very quickly. I just got to celebrate the fact that this house is set. This house is set. Oh, God. This house is set for a move of God that's about to shake this nation for the glory of God like, oh. Now, listen. I know y'all don't know me. You'll know me after the night, but listen. I want you to, and I know why we're here. God providentially set this moment for us to be punctually present in order to usher in a move of God that's going to transform the landscape of America. This election is not about Georgia. Oh, God. This is a kingdom move that God's about to cause a shift in this nation, in this world, through the election of Senator Reverend Dr. Raphael Warnock. Tell you, we're about to pray into the Senate. Oh, God. Don't be timid. Shake on somebody and say, see, we're about to praise him into the Senate. No. Touch somebody. We're about to praise him into the Senate. There are several people who are going to pray tonight and speak. I want you to hear from Dr. Cynthia Hale, and after she finishes, I'm going to come back here. Listen, let me say this to you. My God, that's all over me. Would you put your hand on somebody's shoulder and say, neighbor, there's so much power in your prayer that you can praise people into the Senate because the other side is scheming, but we're praising. And when we praise, oh God, do y'all remember Jehoshaphat? Do you remember when there were three nations lined up against Judah? But Jehoshaphat had the prophecy, we're going to praise first. And they put the praises out in front. Will you tell your neighbor, Raphael Warnock got the praises out in front? And if we praise loud enough, God's gonna shake this thing up. And they won't know what happened because the power comes from on high. I'm closing this. Bishop Murphy, the Lord said to me, it's time to kingdom over the government. I need about seven people here. Tell your neighbor, the kingdom of God belongs over the government. The kingdom should never be subordinated. So what God is doing by sending this man of God into the U.S. Senate, he's putting a man there with a kingdom identity, kingdom mentality, kingdom authority, to establish kingdom territory. Come on, say kingdom identity, kingdom mentality, kingdom authority, and kingdom territory. So that the policies of the man will look like the kingdom of God. That's how you attack poverty. That's how you elevate education. That's how you, that's how you honor the Voters' Rights Act. That's how you stop this nation from putting people down who needs to lift it up. And so I decree and declare tonight that you were on God's schedule to be a part of this transition, just like we were. And as Dr. Cynthia Hill comes to talk about the vote, I want you to understand that when we praise and when we vote, the nation, lastly say this, as for me and my house, as for me and my house, we vote. As for me and my house, we vote. And if we can get every household leader in Georgia to go home and tell everybody at your house, you've got to vote. You can't just talk, you got to vote. There's a hero in the civil rights movement. Her name might not be known. She was 15 years old. Claudette Colvin, 1955 of March. She and her school friends were on a bus, and the bus driver ordered them to give up their seats for a white woman. Claudette, at 15 years old, said no. It was Claudette's protests that inspired Rosa Parks. You know, you don't know 15-year-old Claudette. Will you tell your neighbor, one person whose name is not known can change the world? So don't underestimate your vote. Your vote can change the world. And tonight we're going to hear from an anointed man after Dr. Sith Hell comes, because one person can change the world. And we're doing it for a young lady like Claudette, who believed. I want you to open your mouth and celebrate Dr. Cynthia Hale as she comes to give us our voting orders. Come on, praise God for her.
Tonight, come on, can you give him some, can you glorify him? He is the one who is worthy of all praise, glory, and honor. And I am so grateful to Bishop William Murphy, who I have loved for a long time, and Pastor Danielle, for the Dream Center, your awesome ministry that goes forth throughout the world. I heard about it long before I even got here. And so I'm excited to be here with you tonight, excited to hear Bishop Dixon. He didn't leave me much to say, but this is what I want to say to you. He's already told you why we need to vote. To end voter suppression, to improve our educational system, to provide affordable health care and housing, to help those people who cannot help themselves. You've already heard that we need a prophet in politics. We already have a prophet in the Senate, and we need to send him back. Amen. And it's really very simple. I want you to vote like you praised in here tonight. Do you hear what I'm saying? I thank the bishop. God will overturn suffrage when we praise. But we must also vote. Do you hear me? Being in here giving God praise is half the battle. We have to do is go to the polls Monday through Friday, and then next Tuesday to vote. And if you've already voted, call all your family members and friends, every person that you know. Speak to people on the street and ask them, have you voted? I want to ask a question. If you've already voted, hold those hands up high. Amen. Now I want you to look at your neighbor and say, when you gonna vote? When are you? This is a room filled with power. powerful people who can make some things happen, not only in Decatur, not only in Metro Atlanta, not only in Georgia, not only in the United States, but in the world. You have that kind of power and authority. I want you to exercise your authority. Just vote. God bless you.
Come on, praise God for Dr. Hale. Let me say this. We're about to bring the senator across this platform tonight of pastors who caught planes, paid airfare from Detroit, Michigan, from Virginia, from Florida, all over the United States. Why did we come? We came to give you backup, to let you know that you're not in this by yourself. This is about all of us. Because an attack on us is an attack on all of us. And church, if we don't understand how to unite, pray, praise, and vote, we are forsaking the sacrifices of those who came before us. Would you celebrate all of these pastors one more time? Not just across the Atlanta Metroplex, but from around the nation who came to be a part of this. And now, I want to bring the senator, Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee in Houston, put us on the phone together because we understood and be with him. This man of God is taking heat for not just you, but for all of us. Because whenever you dare to stand up front to lead and oppress people to liberation, the oppressor is infuriated. But the devil is a liar. I said the devil is a liar. I want us tonight to praise God and celebrate this man of faith, this man of focus, this man of fight, and this man of future who understands that with God all things are. That's no accident that he's the pastor of the Ebenezer Baptist Church, the cradle of the civil rights movement. There is no accident that he's the pastor of the late John Lewis. There is no accident that he's the for such a time as this. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, children of God, stand to your feet and shake this roof as we receive Reverend Dr. Warnock.
Praise be unto God, the author and the finisher of our faith, and the Christ who is our Redeemer and our Liberator. I come tonight strengthened by the one who, in his first public sermon, simply read from the book of Isaiah, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me to preach good news to the poor." In Atlanta and places like this, everybody's talking about the anointing. But Jesus said that the litmus test of the anointing is the depth of your commitment to the poor. He has anointed me to preach good, open the eyes of the blind, to set the captives free. I want to thank Bishop William Murphy for opening up this great house. And Pastor D, give him a great big round of applause, my brother. So grateful for him, for his wife, for their gifts, for this amazing Dream Center Church. I'm grateful to Bishop James Dixon and this amazing aggregation of pastors from all over the country. Give them a great big round of applause. All over Atlanta and all over the nation. Thank you so much, pastors, for coming. I'm going to defy Baptist gravity and be brief. You're right. She said, "We'll see." Listen, let me first of all just take the music down a little bit. I want them to hear what I'm saying. voting is happening right now, but I want you to know and understand why it's happening. Somebody has seen your power, and they tried to clip your wings. They said we couldn't vote on Saturday because it was 2 days after a holiday. They misinterpreted the law to keep you from voting. They said can't vote on Saturday because it's 2 days after a holiday. And the holidays they lifted up were Thanksgiving, wait for it, and another day that honors the birthday of Confederate General Robert E. Lee. I mean, you can't make this stuff up. Adds insult to injury. And so they said, you know, we our hands are tied. The law is the law, and they're trying to change the law, and you can't vote. And so here's what I did, Bishop Dixon, Bishop Murphy. I prayed. I raised my hands and I praised. I did all of that. I did it. And then I sued them. Sometimes you got to sue somebody in Jesus' name. We sued them and we won. Then listen, the same folk who said, we can't do anything about it. The law is the law. We wish you could vote. You can't vote on Saturday. Our hands are tied. I sued them. The judge liberated them. The judge ruled in our favor, but the judge liberated them, saying, oh, yeah, you can do it. So then the folks who said their hands were tied, in my estimation, then actually showed their hands because they appealed the judge's ruling. If the issue was simply that your hands were tied, once the judge liberated you, rather than spending time trying to block people from voting, busy trying to open the path so that the people could vote. They said their hands were tied, and then the judge ruled and said, yeah, you can vote. They showed their hands by appealing, and we won again. And this is just over the weekend. And then they came back, I believe, Monday and appealed again. Listen, they appealed again. The election's coming up in a few days. So they filed a motion, listen, for emergency relief. Now, what you ought to be asking yourself is, what do they want relief from? Relief from people voting? Relief from the voices of the people and their right to exercise their constitutional right in a democracy? What do they want relief from? That's what you ought to ask yourself. But the good news is we won again, and that's why we're voting. So we were voting yesterday. You can see I voted today. You can vote Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Lift up your, cry loud and spare not. Lift up your voice like a trumpet. Your vote is your voice. Your voice is your human dignity. My beloved, vote. A vote is a kind of prayer. A vote is a kind of prayer for the world we desire, for ourselves and for our children. A vote is a kind of prayer. It recognizes that we pray not just with our lips, but with our legs. And so I'm asking you to pray. Pray Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, and then pray again. And you know what the book says happens when you pray. The book says that the fervent prayers of the righteous availeth much. The book says, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray, if they would seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, hear from heaven, I will forgive their sins and I will heal their land. I feel incredibly blessed that God has chosen to use me, to use us as instruments of God's healing in the world. I feel incredibly blessed that I can write a that caps the cost of insulin so that folk don't have to ration their insulin. I feel blessed that I was able to secure $6 billion for historically black colleges and universities. And that's because, in closing, and nobody believes a preacher when he says in closing, I am a product of the prophetic black church. And when we say the black church, because so many people are busy to try to divide us, let me hasten to say that when we say the black church, never meant anything racially exclusive about that. We're talking about the anti-slavery church, the anti-segregation church. We're talking about the church that was literally born fighting for freedom. The first black United States senator was Hiram Revels, an AME preacher, 1870. 5 years later, you had another black senator. And then it took 100 years. Do you all see what, I want you to see what an extraordinary thing you've achieved. It took 100 years before you could get another one. Well. I'm only number 11. And so I represent Georgia, but I'm informed by the values of the church that gave birth to Martin Luther King Jr. and Fannie Lou Hamer and Ella Baker. And that's the work that I look forward to doing for CIS in the Senate, to the glory of God. Come on, give God praise in this house. We can do it together. We can do it again. We can do it again. We can do it again.
Senator, pastors, can y'all come close? Everybody standing. Let's get ready to pray. Let's get ready to pray. This is a spirit-filled church. We pray in the Holy Ghost here. I want you to open your mouth and pray right now. Come on, do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus. We pray a hedge of protection around you. We cover your body. We cover your mind. We cover your staff. We cover your family. We cover your church. We cover your finances. We cover your future. We decree and declare that you will overcome because of the blood of the Lamb. Your testimony. If God did it before, we decree he's already done it again. And we decree and declare in this holy place, it's already done. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen and amen. Will you help me give God praise for the newly elected, the re-elected Senator Raphael Warnock? I need you to help me give God praise now. Give God praise now. And declare, same grace on him, same grace on me. If God did it for him again, he'll do it for me again. Put your hands together and give God praise in this building. Throw your hands up, say, someday. Everybody, raise it up now. We shall overcome.
in Atlanta, Savannah, and Augusta.
Okay. Listen, we're not stopping tonight. I don't know if she's in the building, but Pastor Tasha's going to be here with the senator on next week. Israel Houghton is going to be here on next week on Monday night. Where they're going to be on Monday night? And Tasha Cobbs and Israel Houghton are going to be here Monday night in Georgia. Keep your eyes and your ears open in Savannah, Georgia. Will you just raise your hands? We shall overcome. Come on, church. We shall overcome. Sing it. We shall overcome. So clap your hands and help me thank God for every pastor, Pastor Flippin, Pastor Carswell, my state bishop, Bishop Lionel Ketchins, all of these pastors, too many to name. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. This is my prayer. Listen, they tell me Pastor John P. Key is in the building and we're getting ready to go to the next level. We shall. Everybody get your phone out. Everybody gonna take a picture of this and we're gonna sit tonight and you're gonna use the hashtag. As for me and my house, we vote. Get your phone out. Come on, everybody, get your phone out. We're gonna make you famous tonight.
We shall overcome. You say overcome someday. We shall overcome.
We ready to go. When y'all receive Contagious Dance, they coming back. We going back to church. Let's go.
Here we are once again. We're crying out for more of you. More of you. Here we are once again. We're crying out for more of you, more of you. We want to go higher. We want to go deeper. We want to go just beyond the veil. So Lord, take us higher and take us deeper. So just beyond the veil, 'cause we know where the power is. We know where the power is. It's in the name. Wanna go just beyond the veil. Lord, take us higher and take us deeper. We wanna go just beyond the veil. 'Cause we know where the power is. We know where the power is. It's in the Thank you for your word, Father, 'cause you said if I believe, I'll draw men. You said if I believe, I'll draw men. You said if you lift me up, I'll draw men. Power in the name. In the name Jesus, we love your name. We know where the power is. We know where the power is. It's in the name Jesus. Seated word. worked before. We know where the power is. We know where the power is. It's all in the name of Jesus. We know where the power is. We know where the power is. It's in the name of Jesus. Oh, somebody who knows there's power in his name, slip up your hands and your voice and say, we know where the power is. Yeah, we know where the power is. Said it's all in the name Jesus. Demons tremble, mountains move as we declare his name. We know where the power is. Yes, Lord, we know where the power is. Said it's all in the name Jesus. And there is power in the name. In the name, Jesus. Everything we need is in his name,
Jesus. Everything we need is in the name,
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
Power in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Healing in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Yeah, yeah, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. We know where the power is. It's in the name of Jesus. Yeah, we call on the name of Jesus.
I dare somebody to call on that name. I dare somebody take a moment and shout that name. His name is still saving. His name is still healing. His name is still breaking chains. His name is still making way. His name is still winning elections. Somebody call the name of Jesus here. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I don't know what you need God to turn around, but I promise you he answers to the sound of his name. So somebody call him because he hears you now. Jesus. 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 Oh.
Somebody call on the name Jesus. Somebody call on the name Jesus. Healer Jesus. Savior Jesus. Deliverer Jesus. My best friend Jesus. All in all, Jesus. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Bishop Murphy is coming, but one more time, somebody shout that name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. This feels like a good place to praise. I say this feels like a good place to praise. Somebody take a moment. Put a praise on it right here. Raise up your voice and do it. Somebody take a moment and give Jesus praise. Give just praise.
Been faithful. They told me that we'll worship the Lord. All my life you have been so, so good. You say it with every breath. With every breath that I am able. Say it. I will sing. Yes. Of God. Ooh. Your hands and say that to him. See it. All my life, you have been faithful. Yes, you have. Yes, you have. All my life. So, so good. See it with every breath. With every breath. See it. I will sing of the goodness of God. Yeah, say it. I will sing of the goodness in the land of the living. I will sing of the goodness of God. Ooh, I know you can. I know you will. So, Lord, do it again. Somebody who knows God still has the power, say, I know you can. Say it. I know you will. See, Lord, do it. Lord, can. Come on, one big choir. Everybody say, I know you can. I know you can. I know you will.
I know you will.
Lift your hands. Say,
Lord, do it again.
Yes. One more time, say it. I know you can.
I know you can.
Say it. I know you will.
I know you will.
Say, Lord, do it again.
Lord, do it again.
Come on, we're going to give them praise. Everybody say it. I know you can.
I know you can.
I know you will.
I know you will.
Say, Lord. All my life you have been faithful. Yes, Lord. Woo. You say it. And I'm so good. Yes, Lord. With every
that I am made.
Woo. Hey, I will sing of the goodness, of the goodness of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
They're still setting up, and we're not afraid of these moments because the presence of God is here. Anybody sense the presence of God in this room? Can you just slip up your hands right where you are in this room? And as good as God's been to you, only you know what he's been to you. But here's the other part, only what you need him to be. Our bishop has a revelation. It says, the Bible tells us to give God the fruit of our lips. It's really saying to give God the confession of his name. So somebody just raise up your hands and just begin to declare not just who you know God to be, but take a moment and declare who you need God to be. Somebody needs God to be a healer. Somebody needs God to be a deliverer. Somebody needs to leave here tonight with your joy restored. Somebody needs to leave your peace restored. So come on, let's not take this moment for granted, but lift up your hands and just begin to declare for a moment who you need God to be. Somebody saying, God, I need you to be a healer. I need you to be a savior. I need you to be a deliverer. I need you to be. That said, take a moment, raise up your voice and declare it now. Who you need him to be. Ooh. You are my peace. You are my joy. You are my strength. You are my everything. You are my everything. You are my everything, yes. Oh, and we give you praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Hallelujah. So, Father, we thank you for this moment in your presence. We thank you for this time in your presence today. Woo! We thank you, God, that you will be exactly who you said you would be. One more time, can we just clap our hands and give God praise? Can we clap our hands and give God praise? Now, this time, for real, with all the energy, with all the strength, with all the vigor you got, let's give God praise for the ministry. John P. Key. Let's do it now. Come on.
Monitor. Oh! Hallelujah. Oh, how
hey, sing it with me, please.
Oh, how
Georgia, I love you. Come on, Atlanta, you already know I love you. Y'all can't let us down. We got to vote, 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 baby. I want you to vote so bad, I tried to do like some others, just change my citizenship for a few months. People are doing any and everything to win. But we have a candidate that stands and built on integrity. I don't have to be embarrassed when I see him come on my TV. Where is he at? Is he in here? Man, I love you. I'm gonna tell you something. Check. You know how to check. I don't think I ever gave a dime politically. But boy, I was scrolling and you said, don't scroll. I was in my truck at the grocery store. You even told me, don't get out the car. And I was honored, honored to be a blessing to your campaign. Don't forget me, I love you for real. I'm your Uncle John from now on in. You need me. Between now and then, call me. Where I go, people show up. I need to be here at one of the polls just outside singing an old John P. Key song. If I showed up at the polls, I can sing one of them songs where I don't even really need a band. Let me turn this church into some wood flow. Where you at, man? Can I get a wood flow check? I need it louder than that sound. I need that wood flow up in the front. Hit it again. Turn it up again. I need a little bit more. A little bit more. Give me some more. I'm going to deal with that right there. So if you turn your TV on, you see me outside and in Georgia, sing me. And I don't care what they say, bring me some water. Hit it. Mansion now.
I feel it.
Mansion now.
I believe God's heart is there.
Reach up and get you some. Reach up and get you. By faith I believe it, yeah. One right here. I might show this one. There's a lily
in the valley, bright as the morning star.
There is a lily
in the valley, bright as the morning.
Deliverance
in the valley.
From me out.
Out of the valley.
Oh, gone.
Out of the valley.
Oh, gone.
Out of the valley.
And down there.
Out of the valley.
Break it down for me. Y'all clap your hands. Where you at, Lena? Turn the guitar player up. Clap your hands. Sticks, it's a lady in the back still clapping. Young PG fans, start clapping now. We gonna take them way back. Y'all remember this part? When I stop clapping, you're gonna push me. They push me.
worship.
In your believing,
y'all got to get in the mic.
And all in your prayer.
Now everybody in here say,
your blessing.
Oh yeah. Where my believers at? Where my nephew at? Yo, Ken, play me a bass line, right? Come on, Ken. Leland, I need a church guitar, quartet guitar. Y'all don't know nothing about that in Georgia. Right?
It's coming to me.
Think of something you need God to do today. It's coming to me. I preached this morning. He's perfecting the thing. It's coming to me.
It's coming to me.
Yeah. Bring it way down. Some of y'all looking cute. And this is the end of another month. Everything you just got through paying is due again. So I'm going to ask you again. Those that are expecting a miracle in the next 72 hours. Don't make me pay some mortgages in here. I'm able. Don't let these Walmart sweatsuits fool you.
It's coming to me.
It's coming to me.
It's coming to me.
I wish the house would say,
it's coming to me.
Shed a little louder.
It's coming to me.
Now everybody clap your hands like you're going to receive it. Because it is the Father's good pleasure. I say it is the Father's good pleasure to give you what's already yours. Now say it.
Your blessing.
Your blessing.
Your blessing. Say
your blessing.
We gotta go, go to the two.
Joy, joy, joy. In your believing.
Y'all scream this off.
It's all in your faith.
One more time, the whole church. Open your mouth and say, your blessing.
Your blessing.
Your blessing.
Sit down, sit down, sit down in here. Sit down in here. Honoring this amazing man of God who I met in his college days. Yeah, he's somebody's preacher. He's somebody's teacher. But he's the most underrated singer in the universe. I promise you, I adore this man of God. I respect him. I've been his Uncle John for years before everybody caught wind. I respect you and I love you. I was singing worship songs, and I know he looks 23. But I was singing worship songs years and years ago when he was an older teenager. That's why I want these young people to know I respect all my godsons, Kirk, all of them, coming into arenas and allowing people to worship. But I need the babies to know something. Worship wasn't invented in the last 3 years. I
I wrote this song almost 38 years ago. 38, wow. And it'll still work in your Sunday morning service. I'll give you the honor. I'll give you the ever and ever. Up your name, yeah. I wrote another one. I wrote this one about 32 years ago, and it says, stay off the phone and stay off of Facebook telling your business. Pastor, you're lying. Facebook wasn't, Instagram wasn't even out there. Well, this song still teaches you then and now. Whatever your problem, wave it away. Whatever you believe, wave it away. John B. Keeper say, give it to Jesus.
Give it to Jesus.
Give it to Jesus. Now, I wrote another one. I wrote another one. Yeah. This one, the word got out that I didn't write it. They said Richard Smallwood wrote it. Richard didn't say it. Them theys are something else. Now, Morgan Turner, the bass player that used to work with me, he was in the conversation. He didn't say it, but he was sitting there. My daddy said, if you sit there and you don't say nothing, and I'm from Durham, North Carolina, outside the county line. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And we dusted down there. I ain't ashamed. I didn't put no lotion on until I was about 21. We dusted in Carolina. And this song I'm getting ready to sing, it's not a DC, it's not a DMV, it's not a DC, Maryland, or Virginia song. It's a Durham, it's a dusty song. This ain't no light skin song. Just a dusty song. Statistics. Statistics say at least 300 of y'all in here know this song. Here it go. Come in the house. Come
in the house.
Lord Jesus, you're welcome. Let your glory fill.
Let your glory fill the house.
Yeah.
Glory fill the house.
Lord Jesus, you are. Bishop was singing of it. He's already here. He's
in the house.
Sing it one more time. Sing.
In the house.
Sit down in here. Sit down. Sit down in here. I'm going to sing another one right quick. I forgot how I started. Hold on a minute. I'm over 60. Come here, Jeanette. I got it. Just came back to me. And for all of you that's laughing, keep living. Because everybody over 50, let's go and tell them a secret. Once you turn 50, you will walk into a room. And you'll just look at the room. You'll turn around about 3 or 4 times. Because you have no earthly idea what you came in there to get. Shout out to the security at this church. Oh. Reverend Warnock, John P. Key. Boy, they got secured like it's the real stuff too. And I came in church early because I wanted to watch them, just see what they, you know, because they look good. I wanted to see if they knew what they was doing. And you act up. Now, before I got saved, I went to jail several times. And one time I went to jail, a man didn't arrest me. It was a canine. Chased me behind the store and told me what to do. I'm probably not supposed to tell this, but I'm the oldest. They got it all over here. Don't even think about it. Last week I was in concert, sold out concert, and a man acted up in there. He was dating somebody, he wanted his ring back, and he thought he could get it back at a John P. Key concert. Get my ring back. I ain't know what he said. Anytime you holler and it ain't got nothing to do with Jesus, hold my white bag up. I got my Bibles all in there. Hold it up. That's what I carry with me. In case you holler wrong and I need to get to the bus. But let me tell y'all something here. Yeah, you act up in here, I'm gonna fall over to the right. And when I come up, I need y'all to stay down till I tell y'all to come back. Oh, we have drills at my church. When I say get low, I need everybody to go left. Just go left, just take your head down. Get low. Everybody that didn't get low, you the one gonna get popped in the forehead, you. He know I'm telling the truth. You come in my church acting a fool. It ain't gonna hear click, click. That ain't gonna be a gun, that's gonna be the door. We gonna lock it up, cause we gonna handle it in-house. We just gonna handle this. We gonna pray for you, or I'll be doing your service, one or the other. Take care of your pastor, take care of your bishops. You that have pastors here in Georgia. I mean it. People are losing it, and they wanna show out. But you remember when we was little, before we went in Roses or Woolworth, grandmama say, where you show out at? Shh, can't finish it in the church. Or maybe y'all version wasn't like ours. Get ready to sing a song here, a tune here. Statistics say 90% of y'all remember it. But tonight I'm gonna try to do the song. I never normally do the whole song. Tonight I'm gonna try the whole song. I pray my band don't let me down. Let me do a little version to start it, and then I'm gonna shut up and let them come in. I do. Worship you. Yeah, ladies sing, oh how excellent,
oh how good
is your
presence.
We will
measure
me. I do.
I do worship
need to hear y'all singing with us. That's it. No more. Thank y'all so much for loving us. I'm getting ready to rock all those songs y'all told me to sing. I'm going to put them in one good song. Thank you again to the security. They got language that we don't know. I saw them. I checked out big dude in the corner. He was like, 23, 24, 24. I don't even know what that means. But by that time, Bishop came downstairs. I said, whoa. I got it 3, 21, 22, 22. Love it. Y'all singing in here too. Jeanette, you need to consider this for the Atlanta video. I'm recording John P. Key live. Reunion. I want to do it in Atlanta, Houston, St. Louis, Charlotte, and Detroit. Them old songs. There's some good songs, them old songs. I want to do something I haven't done. Sticks, stay with me. I'm going to try to talk to you in the spirit, elevate beyond Justin Bieber. Sorry, I had to do it. Chris actually played on the live. And other band members, this is a new band, give him a hand. Old band got real busy. They started working with everybody, and I applaud that. Go work. But don't put a date down that you had a mind, didn't call me and tell me, I didn't have that one. Yes, you did. You booked on top of mine. Let me tell you, yeah, and played themselves. Now the people they were out with, don't even call them back. Yeah. Y'all better leave us OGs alone. We've been doing this for years. So this is the new band. They do an amazing job. Clap your hands for them again. Clap your hands. But I still don't think they know my old stuff. But we're gonna work it. We're gonna play this one in the spirit. It starts in A flat, but it starts with a drum cadence. And I need to sing this because one of the security guys told me this is his favorite song. So I'm gonna go and try it. If I mess it up, I'm gonna keep singing, and then they messed up. I didn't. Give me a drum cadence, sticks. That's pretty good, right there. Tempo's good. Bass player, rock something for me in A flat. Leland, play. Organist, scream me an A flat on top, real quick. No rehearsal, we just showed up tonight. Song goes like this. I decided to take a stand, not knowing I'd lose 2-3 frames. But I'd rather live right. Yeah, Jeanette pay on her light bill. Lift up my hands. Oh, look our children stand. Money, cause I'll give you. Oh, somebody stand. Yeah, stand for holiness, stand.
For holiness, stand.
Stand for righteousness. God bless her. This lady right here. Hey, right down the front. Give her a hug. Bless her.
My.
Thank you, love. Stand. Look at your neighbor and say, you stand. Yeah. Sit down. I'm gonna tell you about jumping up knowing all my songs. I'll pay your house off right in here. Bishop, they told me to give from here. Please remember his name right now. Everybody listen, the name finally came to me in Atlanta. Ah, yes. Why do I give like I do? No music. Why do I give like I do? I need to tell you. Jeanette, how long have you been with me? How long have you been with me now? 37 years. 30, watch this. 37 years ago, I'm in Atlanta with that old burgundy bus we used to drive. It broke down on the street. But we had finished our concert, but we still couldn't get home. I've looked for him for years. Somebody told me he passed. Somebody in this room has to know him. He was Bishop Joe Price. He had a radio broadcast that came on at 6 o'clock in Atlanta. We were broke down. They said, well, we can't help you fix your bus. Some saints stopped by, but we can take you to our bishop. And he doing a broadcast and maybe y'all can sing a few numbers. We went to the broadcast for Bishop Joe. If he has any descendants, I need to know them. I need to really bless them. Really. I mean, not bless them. I'm talking about really bless them. If there's a wife alive or something, somebody do the homework for me. I'm ready to do this. Watch this. When I was leaving, he fixed the bus and he said, come here. He gave me $100. $100 back then was $2.7 million. $100 was $200. He gave me $100 and he told me this. He said, if you, every time you go into any church to bless God, he said, if you sow into the people of God, God will bless you. When I tell you I won't for nothing, I need to tell y'all that again. Not bragging. Amen. Amen. I went to purchase something, a business deal, Bishop, and they denied me. I was offended. Deny me? My credit's beast. Right, that part. I mean, they denied me with an attitude. And it was a huge business deal. It was a house, it was some property, it was everything. And they told me no. I was offended. Everybody listen to me. I got offended, and I went into church by myself and laid on the altar, and I said these words. I said, if I was a white man, I wouldn't have these issues. And God beat me up. He said, what did you say to me? You've never played by system. You've always played by faith. You trusted me. Why would they deny me? $22 million on a land deal. So not only do I have a little bit of money in the bank, I got that deal. What you deny me for? I was upset about it. But after I fell on my face, God said, you better trust me. I really told this to encourage somebody who's been told no. I was in Jacksonville, Florida. One of my friend's churches, he has a restaurant there. Vaughn, absolutely. And I'm sitting in front of it, and I never tell Vaughn when I'm there because he'll come over and try to buy my food, and I don't want to do that. I want to bless him. So I'm sitting in front of the church a couple weeks ago, and y'all know me. We blessed the whole restaurant, the serving people, the cooks, the people standing in the hall saying, who are you? We blessed everybody. A Bishop Trimble called me from California. I'm flying with the story. He said, I need you to bless somebody, John. There's a blind man in Mississippi. He's between jobs. I need you to bless him. Friend, that's his friend. And I said, Bishop, you've never asked me for anything. Trimble is his name, Alton. But you've already, he sows into me just because the sun comes up. Always, for years, he's just sown into me. We'll be at church and this huge check of comments from him. He said, I'm sowing into you. When I went into Jacksonville, Mississippi to bring water and goods, he sowed into me. He blessed me. Watch this. I said to him on the phone, what you say? I'll find him. He'll have no worries. Housing, whatever he needs. I got it. When I committed to that, my phone rang. It was Sheila and Charisma Evans. I didn't want to answer the phone because I got sick of them telling me I was being denied in that deal. But I finally answered the phone. Here we go. And they said, Pastor, where are you? I said, I'm sitting in front of a restaurant. Just got through feeding the group. We're on the Florida tour. Said, we got a phone call this morning. The lady that was in charge of your accounts, her daddy got sick. So they took her off of your account. And they put another lady in. They said, she walked in and said, John Peakey, and then Anita Prayer Peakey. She started checking the boxes. Approved, 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 approved. Approved, 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 approved. Approved, 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 approved. God gave me everything I wanted plus 300,000. High five somebody and say, wait on the Lord. He's perfecting that thing for you. Now take 12 seconds and lose your mind in here. Dance like something's getting ready to happen. Yeah, I dare you, right in your little circle, praise him. Miracle. Too low, go to A flat, go to A flat. Y'all screaming at me. Miracle.
Miracle, come in my way. made it fair. He made it fair. Everything the devil tried, God made it fair. He made it fair. He made it fair. Everything the devil tried, God made it fair. Somebody over here scream. Sit down in here, sit down. Somebody shout, it's already mine. Oh, God made it fair. He made it fair. Every trick the devil tried, God made it fair. He made it fair. He made it fair. Everything the devil tried, everything the devil tried, everything the devil tried, God made it, He made it fair. Oh Lord, He did. Oh Lord, He did. Clap your hands in this presence. Sit down, I'm moving, I'm moving. Like a miracle's on the way to your house. I need you to dance declaratively, like it's already. God bless you. God bless you. Rest in your seat. We're moving if you can. Oh, Lord. I said to you, I said I needed you to praise God declaratively. That means you leave Sunday and you jump all the way over into Wednesday and you look back and see what God has already done. It takes some faith to do that. But some of y'all need God to move in your house right now. I need about 7 seconds for those folks. Just 7 good seconds.
She ain't gonna drop it.
A bishop called me and told me he wanted me to write a song. I wrote it. I let him hear it over the phone. This is over 30 years ago. And then he said, "Will you navigate it?" I'd never heard that said to me before. I didn't know what that meant. He said, "To navigate is to do a dummy vocal so I'll know how the song moves." So, Bishop, I navigated it for him, only to not call him back, because after I navigated it, I realized that this song was never gonna leave North Carolina. He was angry at me for about 2.5 years. And then he said, "Will you sing a song with me on my record at the time?" He said, "Now I'll forgive you." And I said, "Yes." I went in the studio and it was the highest song I'd ever heard in my life. I said, "I can't sing those notes." So I called him that morning. I just finished Eric Matthews. I said, "Bishop, I can't." I don't even think he was a bishop, he was a pastor. I said, "I can't, that song is so high. And I've been up all night in the studio." And he said these words to me. It's a dangerous thing to say this to anybody from North Carolina. He said, "Oh, no problem. I knew you couldn't handle it anyway." I got a bottle of aspirin and went in that morning and sang. If you Google that song today, it's the highest song I ever sing, and I will never sing it again. I did that song for him. So what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna do the song I did with him, and then I'm gonna sing the song that I took from him and became a national treasure. Here's his song first. His song went like this right here. It's it. Everything's gonna be
alright now.
Think I'll make it.
Anyhow.
Everything's gonna be
alright now.
I'll make it.
Think I'll make it.
Yeah.
Anyhow.
Everything's gonna be
alright now.
So now I'm getting ready to do mine. Can I hear the loop in the front, please? Oh, that's all I need right there. My niece Tasha is here. Ken. Take a deep breath, because we're getting ready to really rock this place, and then I'm gone. I love you. Let me come back. Don't wait a year either. And next time I'm taking that elevator, that's too many steps for Jesus' people. But God just gave me a 5-story house, so I've been practicing. I'm moving again. Y'all ready? Everybody sung this song. The grandma choir, the great grandma choir, the duck choir, the children choir, the little angels, the sunshine band, the little devils, whatever y'all call them. I even put the song in the movie about my daddy in 1940. I wasn't even born yet. I even let Mahalia Jackson sing this song in the movie. So folk would be at the movie saying, "I told you John P. Key didn't write that." Here it is right here.
Oh,
version.
Sure.
Won't it do it? The Lord will. Won't it do it? Good God Almighty. The Lord will. Can I get a witness? The Lord will.
Sure.
Sticks. God of mercy. Freed from
from something. Help me say, I'm delivered.
I'm delivered.
In my story.
Here's my story.
Oh my God.
Life and favor upon me. You are.
Bring it down. We're getting ready to go. I love y'all so much. Thank you for the love. Thank you for the divine koinonia, the real fellowship. Turn that bright spot off for a minute, if you can. That bright spot off. Turn that off for me. Kill it for just a few seconds. We're gonna do something in here. Yeah. Yeah. Turn it off, turn it off, turn it off. Turn it all the way off if you can. Everybody with a testimony? Everybody with a testimony, a real one. Turn the light on your phone and just start waving it. Start waving it. I need the cinematographers to get on the stage so you can capture this right here. These are the people that have a legal right to bless God in this house. Bishop, look at it, look at it, look at it. Wave like you got a story. And here's what's so cool about your story. Because Jesus died specifically for you. You don't owe nobody no explanation for what you come through. Oh God. It's about to get real sweet in here. Watch this. Everybody sing this thing. You don't know my story.
You don't know.
Oh God. Say it again. So you don't know my story.
You don't know my story.
Hey, hey, hey. Say it again. You don't know my story.
You don't know my story.
Sticks, play it with me like this. Say, you don't know my story.
You don't know my story.
We're gonna do that one again. Move your neck when you say it. Say, you don't know my story.
You don't know my story.
Now everybody say this. Say this, say, I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
Oh God. Say it again. Say, I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
We're gonna turn into the choir. Find your part. Soprano, alto, tenor, find your part. And let's say it together, say, I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
Said I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
Know that I am.
I'm blessed.
Am, yeah, yeah,
I'm blessed.
Am, yeah, am, yeah, am, yeah.
I'm blessed.
I'm delivered.
I'm delivered.
I like that part. Just out of your mouth, sir. I'm delivered.
I'm delivered.
Let's do the whole thing. So, I'm delivered.
I'm delivered.
Here's my story.
Here's my story.
Life and favor.
Life and money.
Make noise in here. I love y'all. Thank you so much. I can't walk out without singing the anthem. Somebody came to hear the anthem. And I need you to carry this anthem with you for the rest of this year because God's not done. We're at the 11th hour, but God's not done. Preachers, start preaching, it's over. And know that God's not done. I promise you, it's gonna show up at your house. I'm going old school. This is for everybody over 35. Walk up right now. It's me. It's me, oh Lord, I'm standing.
I am standing in the heat of
the
fire.
Security man.
Your
blood is
me. Oh,
Break it down for me real quick, real quick. Altar's already filled. But there's about 45 more people that have a need tonight. And they just want to lay it at the feet of Jesus. If I'm talking to you, start making your way this way. Bishop, jump up here with me right quick. If I'm talking to you, get out of that seat and come here. You just have a need. You want God to bless you. I want the saints to stop being afraid of the altar. Thank you, Lord. Keep coming, keep coming. If you brought somebody with you tonight and they've been bugging you about an issue, you come with them, grab them by the hand. And me. Keep coming, keep coming. I love y'all so much. Keep coming. Keep coming, keep coming. Try to press your way in the middle if you can a little bit. Make room, make room, make room. Oh, thank you, Lord. Keep coming. Those in the middle, come on up just a little bit. Make. And this was supposed to be a concert. The devil is a liar. This turned into a deliverance service. Oh my God. Somebody's sick or a family member's sick. Don't miss this opportunity. Get in this aisle. Get in this line. Here, get here. Oh my God. No, 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 no. Night. I don't know what you came here for. But by your faith, by your faith, that it's already done. Now what you gotta do is clap like it's so. Minister, break down.
I was sharing the word this morning, and the Bible says in Exodus chapter 39 that Moses blessed them. And the Lord said something to me this morning, Uncle John, that I hadn't heard him say, that God had given me the authority to bless his people. The Bible says in Exodus 39 that Moses examined the work according to all that God had commanded him. And the Bible says when Moses saw that the people had done what God had commanded him to do, the Bible says that Moses blessed them. And the Lord told me this morning to tell you to have an expectation that God is about to bless you again. For you not to let the devil steal 35 days from you. I don't know what you need God to do, but God said to tell you, I got enough time and I got enough days. If God could create a yes, surely he could turn your situation around in 35. I want you to get an agreement tonight with the people who are standing around you that God is about to bless you again. And God gave me the authority to decree a blessing over your house. I decree and declare that you are blessed in the city, that you are blessed in the field. Throw your hands up if you want. It's coming in, and you are blessed going out. And whatever enemy rises up against you, God's going to give you grace to defeat that enemy. They're coming at you one way, but they're going to have to leave you seven ways. I decree a blessing upon everything you produce. And whatever you put your hand to, God is going to bless it. I decree the blessing of the Lord is all over your house. It's not a seasonal blessing, it's a generational blessing. You better open your mouth and declare it. It's not a seasonal blessing, it's a generational blessing. I don't see your mouth move. Not a seat, you can't have it if you won't say it. It's not a seasonal blessing, it's a generational blessing. God is about to bless me so good I ain't gonna be able to spend it all. God is about to bless me so good, I won't be able to exhaust it all. It's going to cover the next 3 to 4 to 5 generations. I declare a blessing over your house in Jesus' name. Amen and amen and amen. Somebody clap your hands like you believe it. Yeah. Listen. Listen, I want you just if you're comfortable with this, I want you just to put your hand on your neighbor's shoulder. Just put your hand on your neighbor's shoulder.
Oh, my.
I want you to. Yes, Lord.
Yeah, Lord.
You know what I just heard the Lord say to me? I just heard the Lord say, nobody has to leave this altar sick.
Nobody.
There's enough power on this altar to deal with whatever kind of sickness you have in your body.
Nobody.
I want you to speak these words. I call your body healed in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name. Call your body healed.
Woman, Dabaso, Rebante, oh, Rabasi.
Call your body healed.
Say it again. I call your body healed.
Call your body healed.
Hey, man, Dabas. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Call your body healed.
I call your body healed.
Call your body healed.
I 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 call your body healed.
Somebody say it. I call your body healed.
I call your body healed.
Yeah, I call your body. I call your body healed.
I call your body healed.
I plead the blood. And I call your body healed. Somebody say, I plead the blood. And I call your body. Listen, we got to move tonight. Did y'all get blessed tonight? I plead the blood.
Plead the blood.
I plead the blood. Yes. Listen, we're going. If you're in this room, and tonight has been amazing. Will y'all help me thank God for Pastor John Keith? He is a once in a lifetime gift. Every now and then you run into people that you know you'll never ever meet again. I'll never forget, I was at Miles College in Birmingham, Alabama.
Birmingham.
And John came there and gave away about $5 million that night. And it impressed me so.
Thank you, God. Thank you.
It came with me.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
People call me generous. That started that night.
Thank you. Accept that for you.
Started that night.
Thank you, God. Thank you.
Phew.
Thank you.
Listen, if you're in this room tonight, you live in Atlanta. Well, let me not say that. The rules have changed now. Listen, one of my babies came to me today. She said, Bishop, I'm so glad to be here. I'm one of your partners. I live in Savannah. I'll be back next month. She came this month to be here. Listen, if you're in this room and you don't have a pastor, you're in this room and you don't have a church. And when I say this room, I'm talking to those of you who are in the online sanctuary. You're in this room and you don't have a pastor. You say, Bishop, how can I join your church? I don't live in Atlanta. COVID changed the game. We have partners now. You don't have to be local to be a part of this global church. You sense something. This tonight wasn't just about your favorite song. Tonight wasn't just about, there was something happening in the spirit. God started knitting your heart to this ministry. You're in this building, you're in this room tonight, and you don't have a pastor. You don't have a church. Let me say this to you. You need a community of faith. Some of you right now, the trouble you have, it's because of the people you're connected to.
Oh, you preach it. You teach it.
In this season, connection is everything. Listen, the Bible says tomorrow will tell. But tonight, if you hear the Spirit of God saying, that's your pastor. If you hear God saying, this is your church. When everybody walks away from this altar, I want you to stay here. When everybody walks away from the altar, I want you to make your way to this altar. This is your church. This, watch this. This is your point of re-entry to the body of Christ. You've been disconnected from church for way too long. And you let somebody run you out of your church. You let somebody run you away from God. But tonight, God creates all of this. God throws a whole runoff election to get you in this room tonight. God, we've been trying to have Uncle John for 30 years.
Tell him it's been a while.
We have one day. But tonight was the night because God knew. That
God
you
knew.
Would be here tonight at your wits.
God knew.
But you don't have to leave here tonight disconnected. You don't have to leave here in this city all by yourself. God is connecting you to a community of faith. You need community. Watch this. You need community, but you need a Moses. You need a trusted prophetic voice who can speak into your life consistently. You're in this room and you need a church. You need a pastor. Do me a favor. Tell them, obey God. Obey God.
Obey God.
Obey God. Well, let me come back on a Sunday. I want to hear the pastor preach first. Listen, your connection to this church has nothing to do with my ability to perform. Your to this church has everything to do with what God is doing in this church. This is where God wants you planted. This is where God's going to grow you. This is where God's going to heal you. This is where God's going to restore your family. Bring your children back. Let me let you go. Listen, thank y'all for coming tonight. Thank you for coming tonight. This is what we're going to do. This has been a good night. I'm going to dismiss you. I'm going to give a benediction. And those of you, I can't do that because some of y'all sneak out. Some of y'all sneak out. I can't do it that way. God's not leading me to do it that way. This is what we're going to do. If you know that this is your church, just come stand right here. Come stand right here in front of me. You know this is your church, just come. The rest of you go back to your seat. I'm going to dismiss you in just a moment. We're going to leave together. We're going to the Waffle House together. Don't leave. This your church. Welcome home, mama. It's your church. People are responding. People are responding to the call of God. Come. I said people are responding to the call of God. Dream Center, y'all still here?
Dream Center.
People are responding to the call of God. Come on. Come on. You know this is your church. You know this is your church. Just come. Come. You know this is your church. You know this is where God wants you. Come. Will y'all help me thank God? Welcome home. Welcome home. Thank you. Somebody say, welcome home. Welcome home. Welcome home. Welcome home. Welcome home.
That was my heart.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Where are those other three people? Will you do me a favor? Look at that person sitting next to you. Say, obey God.
Obey God.
Now, y'all know I hear God in this area. I'm waiting. There are more than three people, but I'm waiting on three. There are three of you in here tonight. This is your church. Don't you let the devil trick you out of this moment of obedience. Where are you? I'm waiting on three people. I'm waiting on three other people. Come on. Come now. If you're in the balcony, walk right around the front. We'll receive you. Come. Come. Will y'all help me tonight? Are y'all praying? Y'all, this is for somebody, this is a life or death moment.
Yeah.
For somebody, they may not make it to 2023.
Amen.
If they don't obey God tonight. Come, baby. Come. Come. You can't afford to live another 35 days disconnected. You can't afford it. Here comes another. That's who I'm waiting on. Come. Come. Welcome home. That's who I'm waiting on. Come on, let's go. Will y'all help me? I told y'all I was more than three, but I was waiting on three. I need somebody in here who is excited about folks getting seen. Folks, I need y'all to help me give God praise for those who are at the altar. Come on, I need a for real praise to go up in the room.
Woo. Bishop,
yeah.
I just believe in my spirit. This is my kind of ministry here. I believe we got two more.
I believe it.
This decision has nothing to do with this building. Somebody is struggling and you need it to end. I need you to know when you get connected to a real word, the scripture says it's higher than the name. I dare you, don't wait another minute, a second. Start moving in this direction, right? Come on, come on. We welcome you in advance. Come on.
Brother,
he loves you. He loves you.
This was good. We on our way to the Waffle House to get us some smothered, what they call them, smothered cover. Smothered and cover. Chunks. Okay, yeah, that's too much. Listen, will you help me praise God for Pastor John Key one more time?
I love you.
We're going. Y'all can receive him now. Y'all can receive him now. Listen, if you're in the online sanctuary and you say, Bishop, help me, I want you to grab your phone real quick. You're going to text this number, 71441. 71441, that's the number. You're going to text this word, DR Salvation. It's one word, no space. DR Salvation. A link's going to come to your phone. Click the link, fill it out in its entirety so you can get in, you fit in. Will y'all help me praise God for those in the online sanctuary who are partnering with us tonight? I know y'all ready to go, but I need a better hand clap than that for those who are partnering with us. Let me be the first to say, welcome home. Somebody put it in the thread. Welcome home. Whew. All right, I'm ready to go. Are y'all ready? Let's get out of here. Everybody standing. Will you just grab them in your right? Tell them you got 35 days to obey God.
Hey.
Tell them you're not ending the year empty. You're ending the year full.
Ending the year full.
Come on, look at them and tell them, year broke.
number.
You're ending the year with more than enough. You're not ending the year sick. You're ending the year healed. I declare the blessing of the Lord overtakes your house, that God gives you safe travel and sweet sleep. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. We'll see y'all next time. Thank you, Uncle John.
Somebody scream, I made it out. I love you. Hey! Man! Bless you. Yeah. God bless you. Yeah. Take a solo. Turn the good job.